I meant to do this a week ago, but I've been busy, so I'm sorry for the delay. Anyways, what I did for Case Queen, I did the same for Hard Magnus, so it's a very long video. It's a very different story with Hard Magnus because there are a lot more variables that come into play, very volatile ones. Your control should be taken into account of much more inside here, since you'll always have to be thinking ahead and ready to avoid death, more so the deeper into the boss you get. This actually took me a long time to get the final recording, because being someone who does cap damage, the game gets kinda monotonous. You just stop caring about stuff like control so much, stuff like minimizing mistakes that cost you precious time, where you could be doing damage, and instead you're just owning him without giving much of a shit. But yeah, I really wanted to make this video and get it out there. I won't speed it up too much because I think it's important I show more than just the damage. Also, I should make it clear that I used Final Cut and Reckless Hunt for this boss. Reckless Hunt for the final phase because we'll most likely be dying too much to make good use of Final Cut. But I recommend Final Cut to get into the final phase much faster because the final phase does take about half of the run. You can use Dark Sight to avoid the balls, but you'll have a cooldown proportionate to how much damage you've dosed. So you'll have to be mindful of how you use that as well. Use Miha Link if you think you could really do without the knockback from his rush. It does help if you feel you need a bit more grip on your control. Use Heal for when your pulse is on cooldown or to save yourself from near death. Use the 150 Hyper to heal also where you think you might need it most. If you get the healing card from Judgment Drawer, it might be important to change it to manual so you have the effect for much longer. It's very dependent on the situation. I did this in the final phase only where I had stay outside the blue zone too much. You learn what works for you in this boss as you practice the boss more once you've got the damage down. I did this with a clean range of 1 mil and the same boss damage and ignore and all the other stats as I had in the Chaos Queen video. I don't have any clip to show here because I'm taking a maple break right now, but you don't need 100% status resist for this boss like you needed at Queen. He only has about 2 debuffs and they're not even that bad. But I would recommend if you've got pets to put the status resist buff on the first pet you summon and also HP for when you really need that instant reaction. That's all. Have fun. You
Thank you. Thank you.